It's time for Money Matters. Joining us today, we have Josh Smith from Strategic Wealth Designers to talk about how a second spike in COVID-19 cases could impact the economy. Josh, what do you think here? Can the economy survive another shutdown?
That's a really tough thing to answer. We are still seeing unemployment numbers rise on a weekly basis, week over week. So we're just now starting to see some of the full effects of the initial shutdown. So a lot of companies are closing, a lot of companies are filing for bankruptcy. So I'm just not sure if we could survive another shutdown.
Yeah, and we know that those shutdowns will likely be made on a state-by-state basis again in the event of a second major spike. Do you think that we're going to see a similar response from state leaders?
I think it's going to be a little bit more measured approach than maybe what we've seen in the past. I know, Florida, for instance, has said they're open for business, and our neighbor up north, Indiana, as well. But I think there's a lot more information available, and I think a lot of local and state governments have a lot more information. They're going to take a little bit more measured approach probably than they did previously, just because of the unintended consequences. I mean, it's great, the ideal of trying to protect everyone's health, but when you shut down the economy, you can also indirectly affect everyone's health as well by shutting down everything.
And of course, a lot hangs in the balance of the upcoming election. How do you think that's going to factor into a response on the local and or national level?
Over the next couple of weeks, I think you may see some additional volatility. So for any of your viewers who are out there, I encourage you to have some of those strong safety nets. A lot of the polls right now are showing Biden in the lead. But as we remember from 2016, I would say at this point, it's anyone's race. I think what the market would like, though, is the day of the election or the day after, they would like to have the president be announced, whoever that is. What the market definitely will not like if there's a lot of limbo or uncertainty about who our new president or our new political leaders are going to be.
We know it's going to take a while to count all those votes, so it could be a while. Something to consider. Josh, thank you.
Thank you.
For more tips to make your money matter, visit our website, WKYT.com. If there's something you'd like us to discuss, send your request to news@WKYT.com, and we'll talk about it here. For WKYT, I'm Andrea Walker.